also with you.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. So let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Father of the eternal Word, in whose encompassing love all things in peace and order move, grant that as your servant, John Keble, adored you in all creation, so we may have a humble heart of love for the mysteries of your Church, and know your love to be new every morning. In Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the good news.
A reading from the Lamentations of Jeremiah. The thought of my affliction and my homelessness is wormwood and gall. My soul continually thinks of it and is bowed down within me. But this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercy never comes to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul, therefore I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good that one should wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm is, your love is before my eyes, O Lord.
Your love is before my eyes, O Lord.
Give judgment for me, O Lord, for I have walked with integrity. I have trusted in the Lord and have not faltered. Your love is before my eyes, O Lord. Test me, O Lord, and try me. Examine my heart and my mind. I have not joined the company of the false, nor consulted with the deceitful. Your love is before my eyes, O Lord. I hate the gathering of evildoers, and I will not sit down with the wicked. I will wash my hands in innocence, O Lord, that I may go about your altar. Your love is before my eyes, O Lord. To make heard the voice of thanksgiving and tell of all your wonderful deeds, Lord, I love the house of your habitation and the place where your glory abides. Your love is before my eyes, O Lord.
We stand with the Gospel of your evening. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up to the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, Blessed are the pure in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated for a moment. So today in the church we remember John Keble, a priest, a tractarian and a poet. Born in 1792, the son of a priest, John Keble showed early brilliance as a scholar, becoming a fellow of Oriel College in Oxford at the age of 19, just a few years before his ordination. He won great praise for his collection of poems, The Christian Year, issued in 1827, and was elected Professor of Poetry in Oxford in 1831. He was a leader of the Tractarian movement, which protested at the threats to the church from liberal developments in both politics and theology. He nevertheless did not seek preferment, and in 1836 became a parish priest near Winchester, a position he held until his death in 1866. He continued to write scholarly books and was praised for his character and spiritual counsel, yet he's best remembered for a sermon he preached in Oxford, considered to be the beginning of the Oxford movement, delivered on this day in the year 1833. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in every age you raise up pastors and leaders for your church to reflect the light of Christ and to lead us in the way of holiness. We thank you for those who have been shepherds of your flock. Bless your church today with gifts of care and nurture, and give a pastoral heart to all bishops, priests, and deacons, strengthening them, all who are called to be leaders of your people. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We thank you for the gifts of grace in the life of John Keble. Give wisdom and insight to all in authority in church and state, that they may use their power for good and the benefit of those over whom they are set. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We thank you for those who give pastoral care to the sick and the suffering. Help those who are distressed through following bad advice. Have mercy on those whose lives lack purpose or direction, and bring them the care they need for wholeness and healing. We remember at this time those who we know who are ill, praying by name for Brenda Prophet, George Hancock, Eva Skelly, Kelly Burgess, Vera Simmons, Irene McConaughey, Mary Wheelman, Frankie Dunn, and in the silence of our hearts, any others in need of our prayers today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We thank you for all who have worked to lead others in the way of truth and are now at rest. Grant us in this life the spiritual guidance and pastoral care that will lead us to eternal life. We pray for those who have died recently and those whose anniversary of death occurs at this time, praying by name for Ronnie Smith, John Dodson, Peter Hewitt, Jean Cavender, Heather Ratledge, and Anne Stevenson. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Please stand if you're able for the peace. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. And the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Simon, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever.
Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Let us pray. God, shepherd of your people, whose servant John Keble revealed the loving service of Christ in his ministry as a pastor of your people. By this Eucharist, in which we share, awaken within us the love of Christ, and keep us faithful to our Christian calling. Through him who laid down his life for us, but is alive and reigns with you now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you now.